What is going on, guys? Welcome, welcome. If this is your first time stopping by, hello. How are you? Today, we are going to be focusing on wrapping our interior pieces in carbon fiber, just like this piece that I've got here. To do so, we are going to need supplies. Lots and lots of supplies. Let's go over what we are going to need. First and foremost, gloves. You're going to need plenty gloves for leaving no traces of evidence. Scissors. Nice pair of sharp scissors for cutting our carbon fiber. These are really important for cutting the carbon fiber and not getting any frays or tears or anything like that. Tape is another good one to keep your victims quiet. Tape is another supply that we need for taping off the edges of the carbon fiber to make sure that our cuts don't fray or tear. It's just super helpful. You would definitely want this tape. Just regular blue painter's tape. The cheaper, the better. Next is going to be our little mixing cups. I got these at Walgreens for like, I think $1.25 or so. So I bought like 5 or 6 sheets of these because we just need a lot. You're gonna need a whole bunch of these, so don't be afraid to buy a bunch. Next on the list is something to threaten your victim with. Next is going to be a nice razor blade or a knife box cutter. This is just the one I have. Got it at Wally World. Super cheap. I recommend 2 of these or extra razor blades for the one that you have because they will dull really, really fast with what they're going to use them for. Next on the list is our epoxy resin. This stuff is just pour on high gloss finish. It's pretty thick, really, really easy to work with. All you have to really worry about is the air bubbles with this one. There's no sanding or anything unnecessary involved, and 2 coats really does the trick with this versus some other resins that require up to 3 or 4 coats, and it's just gonna take you a week to wrap your entire interior, and then you're just gonna get frustrated and quit halfway, and then you're just gonna ruin all your pieces and end up spending a bunch of money on buying a new interior. So get something that's super easy to work with. Next on the agenda is Goo Gone, or some sort of adhesive remover. This stuff is amazing for righting the mistakes that we will make in adhesiveness, such as gluing your fingers together and epoxying gloves to your hands. On to the spray adhesive. I'm using Scotch Super 77 because it was in a red can and it stood out to me on the aisle, and I was like, oh, that's a red, so that means it's got to be like powerful, you know, and I'm just gonna get this one. That's why this one is the one I use. It's quick drying, you know, it dries in like maybe a minute or so, which is perfect for what we need it for, and it's very highly flammable, so don't smoke while you're doing this. Next on the list is going to be a UV resistant clear coat. This is important for keeping your pieces from yellowing and fading over time. You definitely want a UV resistant. That is, I can't put enough emphasis on UV resistant. UV resistant. UV resistant! Last and certainly not least is going to be the cardboard box that we've got everything sitting on. You're definitely going to need something to keep your pieces off of the table or the carpet in this case from sticking. So cardboard. I don't recommend newspaper because newspaper is shitty and I just don't have any. Then you're gonna want something to prop your pieces up off the ground. I've got clothespins to hook. I just kind of clip everything and keep the piece elevated off the cardboard. Help the epoxy drip a little bit. I've also used cans to help me prop things off the floor, like a little lid to cologne. Just be resourceful here. I mean, find something to help keep your piece so it's not just resting on there, because you will have the hardest time in the world trying to rip it off of that, and then you have to go and cut all the way around. It's just eliminates a headache to keep it up off the ground. Last and certainly not least our carbon fiber material. I'm going to give a nice shout out to Rocket West Composites for sending me this little sample pack because I couldn't decide what pattern I wanted through them. So they were just like, we'll send you the patterns that we have. First, you've got this crazy MC Escher looking pattern. This would look pretty cool on some interior pieces if you've got crazy vibes going on in your car. I don't know. One of my personal favorites, the Spider-Man suit pattern, or this honeycomb. This goes really well with quilted leather interiors. It looks so good. And then just, you know, plain Jane standard twill weave pattern, like what we've got here. Everybody and their mom uses this stuff, but it looks good. And then just for fun, they gave me some of their silver stuff. Their silver stuff looks really cool, but I'm trying to take the silver out of my interior. I don't want more silver. It also, if you flip it over, is white. So you can have silver or white with this stuff, whichever you choose. But let's go ahead and get started. So for time purposes, I'm only going to be wrapping two interior pieces, which I deem to be the hardest interior pieces in the car to wrap. So I might as well put them on video, because I guarantee you, you will have trouble with these pieces. First, the door handle trim. It's just awkwardly shaped and curved, and it's there's not a whole lot of room to tie things off back here, so I will try and be as in-depth as possible as I can about wrapping this piece. And the second is the shifter trim bezel, because there's just a big hole in the middle, and you've got to do a lot of cutting and relief cutting and making sure everything fits properly, and it's just going to be a bitch to wrap, and I'm kind of dreading wrapping this piece, but we will get her done. So let's go ahead and start this process. So first thing you're going to want to do is get your carbon fiber piece and measure out your pieces. You're going to want to leave just enough space to wrap the corners up and around to get that really good seal. So I've left about an inch or so all the way around each piece to play with. You can always remove some, but adding some is, it's not fun. It's just not fun. So when measuring out your pieces, this is where the blue masking tape comes into play. You want to measure out your pieces with tape, because when you cut carbon fiber, it's loosely woven, as you can see here. These fiber pieces, you could literally pull them out and ruin the weave that way. So you want to use the blue painter's tape when you're cutting to muffle their screams when you cut them. Use the blue painter's tape to minimize any fraying of the edges for, you know, just to make your life a little bit easier. So go ahead and cut your pieces cut your measured pieces to size, and then we will begin the next step. Now, when cutting carbon fiber, even with the tape on it, you want to make sure to go slow and steady and make sure you're not messing up the weave at all. None of that fancy slide the scissors thing that your teacher used to do that you could never manage to do because she's some sort of wizard, but just be very, very careful in how you're doing it. Make sure you're not distorting any of the weave. That's super important here, because the tape on the edge is supposed to hold everything in place. And if you distort the weave with the tape on the edge, you're going to have a really hard time trying to fix it. So be careful, take your time, and you should be okay. Just like that. Next thing you want to do is put on your butt inspection gloves and position yourself. I don't know, just make everything easier. Put everything in a good position, because you're going to want to kind of move a little quick here with the spray adhesive, just because it does dry rather quickly. And you want to make sure you've got your piece completely covered in the spray adhesive. Otherwise, your carbon fiber is going to lift in certain places, and you're going to have a wiggly, wonky-looking piece, and you're going to hate yourself because you taking it off is just terrible. Now, before you apply your carbon fiber to the piece, you're going to want to inspect your carbon fiber and push the weave together. Make sure everything's tightly woven, you know. Make sure your weave is good, there's no distortion in it. Be as gentle as can be. caress it a little, let it know that you're there for it. If it ever needs anything, that you'll be there. And if it looks good to you, we are ready to spray the adhesive on and start applying it. So now we are going to spray the piece with the spray adhesive. Ideally, you would like to do this outdoors in a well-ventilated area, but I'm already depressed and want to die anyways, so we're going to do it inside the house. Make sure that when you're doing this, you want to get as much coverage as possible on the sides here. That's really important, is hit these sides. Hit them enough to where they're not dripping, but you got to make sure that they're hitting. Hit? Is that the proper hidden? Hitting? Oh, I have no idea. That sounded like the right thing to say, though. Another thing to watch out for is touching the spray adhesive with your gloves, because you are about to handle the carbon fiber. If you get spray adhesive on the wrong side of the carbon fiber, it is going to stay there. In your finished product, you will see where you fucked up and touched it with gooey shit. So be as careful as you can. Now when you're laying your piece down, you want to lay it from the center outwards, and the entire time you're laying it, you want to place as much pressure towards the center of your piece as possible to keep that weave as tight as possible. That is the goal here, is keeping the weave undistorted. So be careful, take your time. If you mess up, don't be afraid to rip it off and just recut another piece of carbon fiber and spend all your money because you keep messing this up. Once it's on, go ahead and press it into place. Make sure you've got everything good. It is flexible fabric, so you can start to work it down into these corners. Just don't pull. Don't be rough with it. Be as gentle as possible. She's frail. She doesn't like to be messed with. Go ahead and lift away. Make sure you're not sticking it to your cardboard, because that is terrible when that happens. And just get everything where you would like it to be. You can already kind of start tucking it underneath. We're definitely gonna need to cut away a good amount of excess material here, but that is not the end of the world. Kind of went a little short over here on this end. That's okay, we'll make it work, just as long as yours is a little short over there. Alrighty. Now from here, you're going to want to wrap it underneath and just kind of tuck everything away. We're basically just waiting for this spray adhesive to dry. So keep tucking everything pretty tightly so you don't get any bumps or warps or wrinkles or anything like that. Wait for your spray adhesive to dry. Okay, so once your piece is dry and you're happy with it, go ahead and trim off any excess down here and get your piece as close as possible to the border of the edge of your piece. And through the magic of editing, I will come back and mine will be perfect, and you'll wonder how I did that, because something's going wrong with yours and I decided not to film me doing it. Okay, so we've got all of our excess cut off, cut away, and we've wrapped it and taped it all to the bottom. Go through and triple check to make sure that everything is straight and as flush as you want it. Now is the time to correct any mistakes that you have, like, you know, not asking that girl out 3 years ago. Just call it up right now and be like, hey, you know, let's get it going. Yeah. No, but seriously, make sure that everything is straight and your weave is exactly the way that you want it. Try and make sure that there's no tape around the bottom edges here. Like, get it as close to the edge as possible, but make sure that it's not showing straight on, because that tape will be a little bit hard to remove later on if it is still there, because it'll be epoxied in place. Like right here, I've got tape on this corner that I've got to move. But other than that, we are ready to throw the first coat of resin on this bad boy. So I will remove that piece of tape, and I'll come back, and we will start resining. Once your resin is mixed, go ahead and start pouring it on. Like I said, the resin that we are using is designed to be poured onto the piece. So that is what I'm going to do, is pour it on. It's really satisfying to watch this stuff get all like poured onto it and all gooey looking. And then if you got one, I recommend using one of these foam brushes to kind of push everything around to alleviate as many brush strokes and streaks as you can. Just kind of spread it around. This stuff is self-leveling, so you don't really have to worry too much about leveling it off. Just kind of spread it up and around, and if any falls off, scoop it back up and just drip it back on. Want to get as much use out of this first coat as possible. The ends of your pieces are what kind of tend to absorb the least amount of resin, so I like to go really heavy in those areas. But now, get your trusty dusty blow dryer or heat gun, and we're going to gently heat it to release a lot of those air bubbles and things. Awesome. Now that that's heated, this piece is good to go. Now we hurry up and wait for the next... What is this one? It's like 6 to 10 hours for this first coat to like dry enough to get ready for the second coat. You want to apply the second coat when it's like dry to the touch but still tacky. Like if you leave your finger there too long, it'll stick. You want to apply the second coats during that time. Before we move on, I forgot to mention, cover the piece that we just did to minimize any dust contamination or anything like that, or stuff floating around the air that'll stick to your piece and cause rough surfaces. When you're laying your piece down, make sure that the twill weave patterns sort of match up, or they're cohesive together. Like this piece here, my weave is going down to the left. So when I lay my piece down here, I'm making sure my weave is going down and to the left as well, just to kind of keep a cohesive, clean look throughout the interior with this particular fiber that I have here. So be sure to be mindful of that when going throughout all of your interior pieces. Okay, you should have it laid down. Go ahead and let it dry a little bit and kind of start tucking your edges around and working out how you want to do this. Just be sure to not let your piece stick to the cardboard itself, because the spray adhesive goes everywhere, so be sure to pick it up after a second so it doesn't stick to the cardboard. Okay, so from here, I've cut up all my excess around the sides. Go ahead and tape all your corners and excess down first before we start messing with the middle of it at all. Now in the process of taping here, I found the easiest way to get these corners to look good and sharp is to fold a little bit of the material over and straighten it that way so it looks good in the corner. Just fold it over a little bit. We're going to be cutting it off anyway later, so it doesn't matter if it's folded neatly or not, just as long as that corner looks sharp and good. Okay, so what I did was cut the D out of the center, and then I made relief cuts straight up to the center here from inside the D. I just cut with my razor straight up each corner, and then the spray adhesive that we sprayed earlier is holding everything in place straight down. And here we go. Before, go ahead and get your super mega heat gun and pop all of those bubbles. All right, hurry up and wait. And we are back after 8 hours or so. It is just the right amount. What the fuck? I did not notice this a second ago. Ah. Leave it to me to turn the camera on and then notice something wrong. Anyways, we are back. Everything looks to be about good. It's the right consistency of tacky sticky that I want. So I'm going to go ahead and apply my second coat. Came home to find that the guy mowing the lawn scared my dog, so the dog came in here and walked across the boxes that I had set up and ruined our peace. Yep, such is life. Oh well, I can redo it, not the end of the world. And on a more positive note, if later in life you decide that you don't want a carbon fiber interior anymore, it is removable. It's not very easy to remove, but it is removable. Awesome. Okay, so trimming of the edges. Get your murder weapon, box cutter, and find a pretty good place around this edge here to start cutting, really. But yeah, trim away the outer shell. And just kind of get yourself to a point where you can see what you're doing. Because right now we're just kind of trimming blind and I can't really see how close or how far I am from my edge. Ow! And then we're just going to knock the camera over. There we go. Nice little opening. But yeah, go ahead and trim some of the excess all the way around, just to kind of get yourself to where you can see. Because that's what's important here, is being able to see. Okay, once you've got enough out of the way to kind of see your hard lines and edges here, this is where you want to be kind of careful. I like to lay my knife as flat as possible and get down to the hard edge and then just very, very carefully trim all the way to that edge. Be careful, take it slow. This is what makes or breaks your fitment when putting it back in the car. So take your time, go all the way around the piece. It gets to be a little tough up here in the edges because it's a little thicker. Take your time, do it right the first time. It's also a lot harder to peel your piece back off if you mess up from this stage once you get it down to being that flat. So, I don't know, this is where you make it or break it. Okay, we are back. All cleaned up. Everything looks nice. All my edges are good. Everything should fit just fine. So now, it is time for our UV resistant clear coat. From there, you are ready to reinstall it into your interior. And you've just carbon fiber wrapped your interior. It's that easy. Feeling good today. Don't want to die as much today, so I think we're going to do this outside so we don't get all this toxic crap in our lungs. Alright guys, once your UV resistant clear coat has dried, everything looks good. You've checked for bubbles, you've checked for fingerprints, you wiped everything down, polished it. Go ahead and install it back in your interior. Put your interior back together. Everything should look good. I'd like to apologize for this piece being ruined by the dog. I'm just probably going to rewrap it along with this piece once I take everything out again and get around to wrapping it. But for now, I'm happy with how everything else came out. The fitment of this piece, with the way I cut everything, should fit damn near perfectly. Oh, yeah, everything should be good. So just install it, and that'll be the end of that. Alright guys, thanks for watching. Hopefully your guys' pieces turned out just as good as mine did. I'm happy with it. I don't really see much that I need to change. If you found this video entertaining, go ahead and smash that like button. Comment down below with pictures of your interior. I really, really want to see how your guys' stuff turned out. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already. And until next time, I will see you guys later.